everyone. This presentation is a collaborative work of Damla Acar, Alan Kovruğu, Thomas Debris Alazart, Subrat Amanla, Raki Pratiyar and me. Our focus during these 2 weeks was a combinatorial problem, which is classifying spaces with minimal squares. If I want to be more precise, we want to focus on all subspaces S of Fxn. Here, this denotes all polynomials with degree smaller than or equal to n. We want to classify all subspaces such that dimension of a square is small. In order to understand what the sentence is saying, we need to know what is a square and we need to know what is small. To give the definition of square spaces, we take an S as vector subspace of Fx, and we define S square to be all the linear combinations of the products F and G, where F and G belongs to our set S. Also, we have this notation for the span, the angled brackets. Here we see two small examples. First of which, we have 1xx square. These are in a geometric progression, and we have dimension 3. And for this case, we have S1 square, which consists of span of 5 elements here. The dimension is 5. Here we do not have a geometric progression. The dimension is again 3, but this time S2 squared is generated by these 6 monomials. Therefore, the dimension is 6. Let me remind you one more time here. We do not only take the products, but we also have the linear combinations of the products of elements of S. Now, what is small? To understand what is small, we need to first consider the known bounds for dimension of S square. We know that dimension of S square is between, for a finite dimensional space, of course, is between 2 times dimension of S minus 1 and dimension of S squared. Now, for the upper bound, if we take a basis for S, let's call it F1 up to Fn, then if we consider all Fi times Fj's, where I is smaller than or equal to J, this is always a generator set. But for a random subspace, this also constitutes a linearly independent set because in a random set, it is true. Therefore, it usually forms a basis. And the dimension of this is equal to approximately dimension of S choose 2. Therefore, we have this upper bound. But we are interested in the lower bound. So what can we say about the lower bound? We have this characterization. For the lower bound, if we have a subspace with dimension of dimension n, and dimension of S square is equal to 2n minus 1, then we know that this value is attained if and only if S has a basis in geometric progression. By this, I mean this. We have a basis in this form, Fg square, Fg cube, up to Fg 2n minus 1. Okay. Now I can summarize our results in this presentation. We take an algebraically closed field and characteristic of F is not equal to 2. And then if S is a subspace with dimension n and if the dimension S square is equal to 2n minus 1 or 2n, we know S has one of the following forms up to a change of variable. These are the forms. Under certain conditions, we showed it must have these two. It must be have these two forms, and 3 to 5 soon to be proved. Now let me continue with our general approach. In order to develop a general approach, if we consider a subspace of S in Fxn again with dimension of S is equal to n, then codimension of S is equal to 1. Therefore, we can see S as the kernel of a linear functional phi from Fx smaller than or equal to n to F. Here, in this example, you see S is equal to 1x up to x to n minus 1. And if we let phi to be this map here, it sends all of the monomials to zero except the last one. It sends x to n to 1. Then s is the kernel of this map here. Now we want to classify the quadratic forms associated to a subspace and its square. To understand how we do this, we should first understand how we attach to a quadratic form to our subspace. And now we have this map for S, and we know that kernel of phi is equal to S. Then we know S square is a subspace of Fx smaller than or equal to 2n. Therefore, if we have a psi from for any psi from Fx smaller than or equal to 2n to F, if it is onto the dimension of the kernel is 2n, and we can create a psi such that S square is in the kernel, because our S has dimension 2n or 2n minus 1. Therefore, we can always construct a psi such that S square is contained in the kernel of psi. Then this psi induced a symmetric bilinear form defined as here. Psi tilde is from fx smaller than or equal to n times fx smaller than or equal to n to f. And it takes f, g, sends it to psi fg. And we have also a quadratic form attached to psi tilde. It's called q psi tilde. And it is from fx n to f. It takes f and sends it to psi f square. We call this associated quadratic form to S, and we call this associated symmetric bilinear form to S. Now, we are interested in the rank of quadratic form. To understand the rank, we will use a matrix. Now, we will fix a basis F0 up to Fn for Fx with degree Fx smaller than n. Rank of Q psi tilde for any quadratic form is defined by rank A, where A is this matrix here. For the fixed basis, we had associated linear map evaluated at Fi times Fj. And this the rank of this matrix is independent of the choice of basis. It can be shown. Okay. Let's go back to our example. S was this, and we have phi here. The kernel of phi was equal to F. Now we can define psi such that S square is contained in the kernel of psi. We know that S square is the space generated by 1x and all the powers up to x to 2n minus 2. Therefore, this map should, this linear functional should map all of xi, which are smaller than 2n minus 2, to 0. But we have freedom for x to 2n minus 1 and x to 2n. We can send them a and b, and these are determined later. For the first case, letting b is not equal to 0, we know that psi of x to 2n is not equal to 0. And psi of xi is equal to 0 for all other powers. Now we can consider an ordered basis, 1x up to xn, of the polynomials with degree smaller than or equal to n. Then we know that this rank is given by the rank of this matrix here. But here we have 1 times 1, for example, psi evaluated at 1 times 1. And here we have psi evaluated at xn times xn. And we know only this value is not equal to 0, and this is b. If you check, all of them are equal to 0. Therefore, the rank is equal to 1, because we have only one non-zero entry. Now, if we let a to be non-zero, then we will get this map here. I'm sorry, this matrix here for the associated matrix to q phi tilde. Here, we will have x2 to n minus 1, because for this one we are evaluating x to n minus 1 times x to n, and x to 2n minus 1 is not equal to 0. Therefore, we have rank 2. Since no matter these values are, we have two pivot positions in this matrix. Therefore, the rank is equal to 2. Now we saw two examples where rank is equal to 1 or rank is equal to 2. Now a question arises. Are there the only possibilities? The answer is yes. If we consider a basis of S, let's say F1, F1 to Fn, we can always complete it to a basis of Fxn. And here we have F1 up to Fn, and here we have psi evaluated at Fi times Fj. Since all of them comes from S square, and the kernel of this contains S square, this n by n submatrix consists of only zeros. And the only things that can be non-zero is either in this column or this row. But here, there are three possibilities. Either only this is equal to a non-zero thing, or we can a non-zero element here, but since this is symmetric, this will be also non-zero, which makes the rank 2. If we have only this is non-zero, then we have rank 1. If all of them zero, then we are in a degenerate case. This is impossible because of our construction. So rank can only be equal to 1 or 2. Now we have a classification for rank Q psi tilde is equal to 1. Remember, we defined Q psi tilde starting from a subspace S. Now we want to show, we want to find out what are subspaces S with codimension 1 of Fxn such that rank of Q psi tilde is equal to 1. To answer this question, we will use Gauss decomposition. For a quadratic form which with rank 1, we know that we can write it as a square of a linear form. And by using polar form for associated bilinear form, psi tilde, we can show that psi tilde fg is equal to phi of f times phi of g. We defined cone and kernel of q tilde and q psi tilde and psi tilde. This is given by all polynomials f such that q psi tilde f is equal to 0. And the kernel of this bilinear map is given by all f such that for all g, psi tilde f comma g is equal to 0. Now, using this identity here, we can see that if an element is, for example, if an element f is in kernel of phi, then it is in if an element is in kernel of phi, then for every g, we can write psi of phi comma g in this way. Therefore, kernel of psi is equal to kernel of phi, and this is equal to cone of q psi tilde. And now we know that S is contained in q, cone q psi tilde, and we know this equality. We also know F is a non-zero linear map, and we want to classify all S with dimension n, or let's say codimension 1. Therefore, the only choice for S is to be equal to the kernel of phi. Therefore, we find out what f, what phi can be to classify F. We look at what phi 1 can be. There are two cases. Phi 1 is either equal to 1 or is equal to 0. In this case, we use this psi of xi can be written like this if I is smaller than or equal to n. And we know since phi 1 is equal to 0, this is equal to 0. For the other case, if n is greater than, if I is greater than n plus 1, then we, assuming this, we get a contradiction which says psi of f is the 0 map. And with a similar tricks here, we can say that psi of xi is not equal to zero for all I between 1 and n. Therefore, we obtain our S. These are the elements that are mapped to zero, and we know x to n is not mapped to zero, therefore S is that. I have one more slide actually, but I think I should stop.
Thanks.